How's it going, everybody? I know it's been a hot minute since we hit this channel, but we're getting the swing of things. I did a lot of behind the scenes playing of Warcraft Rumble to make sure that the information I gave was somewhat coherent. We're gonna get there. I've been having a lot of fun playing the game still. I'm still super hyped for it. I can't wait until global launch. This game is gonna blow up. It's gonna be the next big thing. Trust me, it's gonna be dope. In this video, I'm gonna be showing you one deck that I've been using to really farm out quests, level up my minis, having a lot of fun with it. It's a Jaina-centric deck. She's going to be the leader. So hope you enjoy this video. If you do, make sure you like, share, subscribe, share with your friends, because since this is an old YouTube channel, it's not going to hit the algorithm the way that we would like. So it's going to live and die off of shares. So if you could do that for me, that'd be great. But otherwise, enjoy the video. What's up, everybody? I know it's been quite a bit. I've been doing lots of studying in Warcraft Rumble, playing around with a lot of decks. And I figured today, let's do our first video and share with you my favorite farming deck. So yeah, this is the deck I use to get in there and farm these quests when I'm trying to level up my minis, and it's going to be a Jaina deck. I know in the first video I said I don't like Jaina, don't choose Jaina as your starter. I still agree with that. I think the best PvE character is going to be this guy, Baron Rivendale. He's going to help you just kind of climb faster, but Jaina does seem to scale really well. Her damage now on range units and on sieges is great, and her ability to make your spells cost one less has become really effective for me as I'm farming these quests to kind of level up. So what I like to have on this deck is I like to have three unbound units. So Blizzard, technically an unbound spell, right? The safe unit, I really like her. I also have a really strong talent on the safe unit that puts her in stealth before her first attack. So she gets to do two attacks before she dies. I like the Worgen, he's unbound as well. I love my Fire Elemental, he's my tank. The Warsong Siege, that's what I'm going to call her, because she absolutely just demolishes things. And then I have my Harpies, which are really good at taking out anti-ground units that don't attack air and ground units that don't attack air. And they're pretty cheap, coming in at 3 gold. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to do a couple missions here. I'm going to keep farming Jaina, I guess. I do want to hard swap to Baron Rivendale eventually to work on him, or even Sneed. I have been working on those characters as well. I'm trying to switch it up, play different decks. This mission in particular, you know what? This mission is okay for Jaina. You do gotta remember that like all the missions are different in this game, which is why this game is such an interesting concept. Because no match, well, I guess that's not technically true. Some matches are the same, but there's like 100 different maps. And so it really increases like your experience when you play it, which I thought was really cool. So if you've done the Scarlet Monastery before, you know exactly what's about to happen. We're going to go in. If we kill one, then the other one will revive. And it goes back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. So, yeah. We got to kill them both at the same time. So we got to kind of amass an army on the left, amass an army on the right, and go from there. So I'm going to wait for the next character to spawn in so I don't waste this Blizzard. You see how it says +3 now in that bottom right corner instead of 4? That's because I summoned in Jaina. And you know what? No, there's no real reason to summon yet. So let's just go ahead and we'll leave that Blizzard unused for now. Okay, so now this ground unit can't attack air if I'm not mistaken. So that's a free kill for us. We'll summon a Kobold to go get that gold mine. We'll throw the Warsong Raider up at homie up here. And now we can bring Jaina in. So now we have units on both sides. Gonna do some good damage. We'll throw our Blizzard wherever it's needed most. We'll kind of wait a little bit. They're both dying pretty even right now. Okay, so there we go. You see Jaina just doing incredible damage to the boss while the Fire Elemental tanks for her. She's in stealth, but we took that guy out at the same time, and away we go. I think we should almost do level guides, like the first clear level guides, because the first time you clear them, there's different enemies. It's a lot more difficult. I think I'll have to make a new account and do that. But as far as farming goes, it's a little bit easier. And so Jaina with the Blizzard, she can kind of come in and she bullies her way through it. Especially with these low-cost characters. Like, I don't have any 5-cost or even 6-cost minis that I'm bringing with me. Let's do one more. Maybe one or two more. And maybe I'll give you a show on the Unbound deck that kind of inspired me to try this one. This is the very, very first level. Maybe the second level after Goldtooth. So this one should be really quick. And what I'm really looking forward to is there's a lot of cool talents that these characters get. Like the Harpies, for instance, they can get a talent that makes them gold miners. So when they pass this gold mine here, they would have actually went and farmed it, which would be great. So I'm excited to level these characters up even further and see how far they can go. I'll let that kobold get through. We're just going to be able to bust through this. This is one of the first levels. The quests, they're kind of random where they send you, right? And I'm not complaining about that because we get free ones like this. And this is a very, very free one. Let's go ahead and throw some more damage over there. I'll throw the blizzard here just to take out that little army that's coming up on my team. We'll throw our wolf up there, and you see Janna just doing incredible damage from range. So she's protected, which is really nice. A character like Kane Bloodhoof, very strong, but he's obviously in danger. So you can't protect him unless you send just another melee character with him. Obviously, you can get hit by AoE damage and stuff like that. Especially for bosses where there's like the rock slide or there's the poison cloud and stuff like that. So Janna can be very helpful in those situations. Oh, we got ourselves a nice purple quest. This should be difficult. And it should give us a good amount, so 174. I'll tell you what, we're going to throw that on our harpies. It won't level them, but it'll get them right on the verge of a level, which is always cool. Ooh, this one's annoying. So for this boss, whenever she kills you, she's going to start at 50% life, which is kind of nice. But whenever she takes out one of our units, she then will eat their corpse. I know, sounds pretty cool. And it is pretty cool. We don't want to send a half-cocked kind of army at her. We kind of want to send one big army at her right away. So what I'll do is I took out that first little bit. And now we're going to let our gold kind of stock up. And what's going to happen is I'll send my wolf at this chest at pretty last second. Like once this fire elemental and Janna make it around to the gold, we'll do that. And then we'll kind of spam summon everything and see if we can't blitz this one down. All right, there we go. And we'll summon this. So he's going to get his gold. We'll take that out. And now I'm actually not going to summon the Fire Ellie because it's a bit too slow. It won't make it there in time. I will summon Janna though because the Blizzard, he will wreck this. And there you go. Actually, you know what? This turned out to be a very, very easy one. We have a good tanky deck. Nothing's too squishy. Something I was playing around with a bit too much at the beginning is I was using the chickens. Now, I love the chickens because they will demolish some of the most problematic units. Like when we're facing the Warsong Raider or the Tauren Charger or a character like, not Kane because he AoEs them down, but like Baron Rivendell or one of those other melee tank minis that come and they absolutely just demolish your base, but they're single target, so the chickens whittle them down super fast. You know what? This is probably one of the worst levels for this because we don't have much air going for us. But with Blizzard, with the Harpies, and with the safe unit, we will eventually get through this one. There we go. Oh, Janna got the kill. Very, very nice. What I'll do is I'll summon the safe unit here. And then she's just going to go around the world, and what she's going to do is just collect those chests so we can keep spamming Blizzard and our Harpies and our safe unit. This is actually one of the boss levels. I forget what... This must be not Angoro Crater. Blackrock Depths, maybe? I forget which world this was from. Everything before this level was so difficult, and then when I got to this level, it was so free because of those chests back there. Yeah, I think we're definitely going to have to do guides for the levels because they're so fun. They're so intricate. They're all unique. And what you just saw is not what the first attempt to clear those levels are. Anyway, guys, that's going to be it for this video. Let me know what you're thinking about this farming deck. I think in the next video, we'll showcase the Unbound deck, which is just Maiv Shadow Song. I really like this deck as well. I think we need to put a little bit more work into it. General concept is every time we summon somebody, Maiv, who costs 6, costs 1 less, and she can be an absolute juggernaut of damage. But we'll farm this deck up a little bit, get these minis a bit higher, and we'll talk soon. So have a wonderful, happy day, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye for now. That's it for the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you like, share, and subscribe. Stay happy, healthy, have fun, and I'll see you in the next one.